Hey guys, it's Marianne, the Frugal Chef. I hope you're doing super well. Welcome to Low Carb Week. We're gonna have a few of these guys because I had lost a bunch of pounds and then all of a sudden I found them again. Oh, now I gotta lose them again. This week, we're gonna be making some egg bites, a kind of a copycat of Starbucks. Very, very easy to make. In fact, that's what we're making right after this introduction. Tomorrow, we're gonna make some broccoli in the oven with lemons and garlic. On Wednesday, we're gonna make some chicken breast with a cilantro sauce, which is really quite special and super easy. On Thursday, we're gonna make a sauerkraut. It's not fermented, but it is kind of like a braised cabbage and vinegar. It's very, very nice. And on Friday, we'll make some air fryer pork chops, which we'll serve with our sauerkraut. I have a gift for you guys at the end of this video, so make sure you stick around. We're gonna make our egg bites today with some pimentos, some scallion greens, some spinach, and I'm gonna put some green chilies in them. You can make these with anything you want. You can do just bacon, you can do ham, you can do broccoli, you can do tomatoes, whatever you like in your eggs, okay? We're making these in 4-ounce mason jars. I'm just gonna put a little bit of all that in each one. I'm only making 4 of these just to show you how to make them. You can make as many as you want, obviously, because you can refrigerate these and have them ready for all week. So that's what they're looking like from the inside. We're only gonna need 2 eggs for these 4 cups, and we're going to blend them. So 2 eggs in the blender. I'm gonna add a splash of water. I am going to use Mexican crema. It's because it's what I have in the fridge. You can use heavy cream, you can use milk if you want, or sour cream, whatever you want. I'm gonna add about 1/4 cup of cream. I'm going to use Colby Jack cheese. Same thing, guys, you can use whatever cheese you want. You can use cheddar, American, Gruyere, Parmesan, whatever you like. So we'll do about 1/4 cup of that as well. I'll put some pepper in here. I'm not gonna add any extra salt because the cheese has salt in it. So I'm gonna go and blend this and I'll be right back. So I am going to divide this in 4. And we're just gonna mix that. If you wanna add a little more cheese on top, go ahead. I'm not going to. So I'm going to cover each one of these with some aluminum foil. We're gonna cook these in the instant pot. But let me tell you, if you wanted to microwave them, you could, obviously without the foil, and in a minute you would have a nice kind of like a souffle-y egg, okay? We're gonna put our trivet inside our pot, and I'm going to add 1 cup of water to the trivet, and I'm gonna place my little cups inside. I adjust the pressure little button in the back. We're gonna turn it on to pressure cook on high, and it's on 7 minutes. And that's it. These Instapots have a little button that you press and all the pressure comes out. So now we can open it. And we're gonna grab these carefully. We're gonna uncover them. So pretty. These are hot, but I want you to flip them over onto a plate, okay? I don't know why that one doesn't want to slide off like the other ones. Uh-oh. Well, that one didn't come out as well as it should have. You can see how fluffy these eggs are. Look at this. Oh yes. It's beautiful. Mmm. Mmm. And it tastes very good. See how easy that was? Very, very easy. Now, you can keep these in the refrigerator and eat them, you know, if you want two a day, whatever, right? You can heat them in the microwave for like 10 seconds and they'll be ready to go. You can also freeze them, but the consistency does not stay the same. They tend to get a little rubbery. So now for our gift. Remember I told you I wrote a cookbook, or I had compiled a cookbook for you guys that was voice activated and supported in many languages? Well, I wanna give the first 100 people that go and sign up for it, I wanna give it away for free. The sign up only means you can use it with the Retrieve app. It doesn't mean that I'm gonna be collecting your email or anything like that. I just wanna gift you my cookbook, okay? So this is how it works. This is thefrugalchef.com. Obviously I'm using my iPad. You go to the menu and here it says healthy and frugal cookbooks. So you click on that. And of course it's gonna take its time. And it takes you straight to, I'm signed in right now, but it'll take you straight to the page where you would sign in. Sign in means you're gonna create your account so that you have access like this to the book whenever you want from your computer, your phone, or your tablet, okay? So then once you're in there, you press on healthy recipes and it takes you to the table of contents. So yeah, so you know, there's all kinds of information in here and I want you to have it for free. So again, first 100 that go on and get it for free. So that's my gift, guys. I hope you enjoy it. And if you have, oh, another thing, you can message me directly from the book. If you have any questions, see, direct message, and I will answer you, we have some nice conversations through the cookbook. Thanks for watching the video, guys. I'll see you tomorrow with our broccoli.